War. War never changes. In the year 1945, my great-great-grandfather, serving in the army, wondered when he'd get to go home to his wife and the son he'd never seen. He got his wish when the U.S. ended World War II by dropping atomic bombs on Hiroshima and Nagasaki. The world awaited Armageddon. Instead, something miraculous happened. We began to use atomic energy not as a weapon, but as a nearly limitless source of power. People enjoyed luxuries once thought the realm of science fiction. Domestic robots, fusion-powered cars, portable computers. But then, in the 21st century, people awoke from the American dream. Years of consumption led to shortages of every major resource. The entire world unraveled. Peace became a distant memory. It is now the year 2077. We stand on the brink of total war. And I am afraid for myself, for my wife, for my infant son. Because if my time in the army taught me one thing, it's that war never changes. War never changes.
You're gonna knock him dead at the Veterans Hall tonight, hon.
You think?
Absolutely. Now get ready and stop hogging the mirror.
Right.
Sir, your coffee. 173.5 degree Fahrenheit. Brewed to perfection. And today's newspaper just delivered.
Grognak the Barbarian and the Jungle of the Bat Babies. My favorite. Sugar bombs. 100% daily value of sugar. More of the same.
Oh, sounds like someone made a sticky. I shall attend to young Sean.
You know, I was nervous at first, but Codsworth's really good with Sean. Well, look at you. How'd a girl like me ever get so lucky, huh?
Jiao, the nights are cold, unseasonably so for Southeast Asia. But for the 5th Infantry, that's as comfortable as an autumn day. All these are mechanized Hellcats to drive any screaming commie memes right into the...
Can you get that? It's probably that salesman. He comes for you every day.
Good morning! Vault-Tec calling!
Vault-Tec? Remind me again?
Why, we're about you, sir, and helping secure your future. You see, Vault-Tec is the foremost builder of state-of-the-art underground fallout shelters. Vaults, if you will. Luxury accommodations where you can wait out the horrors of nuclear devastation. You can't begin to know how happy I am to finally speak with you. I've been trying for days. It's a matter of utmost urgency, I assure you.
What's so important?
Why, nothing less than your entire future. If you haven't noticed, sir, this country has gone to heck in a handbasket. If you'll excuse my language. The big kaboom is... It's inevitable, I'm afraid. And coming sooner than you may think. If you catch my meaning... Now, I know you're a busy fellow, so I won't take up much of your time. Time being a precious commodity. I'm here today to tell you that because of your family service to our country, you have been pre-selected for entrance into the local vault. Vault 111.
Sounds great.
Oh, it is. Believe you me. Now, you're already cleared for entrance in the unforeseen event of total atomic annihilation. I just need to verify some information. That's all.
Tell me more about this vault.
Oh, it has all the amenities of the modern home, I assure you. Not to mention... total protection from nuclear radiation and hostile mutants. A better future underground. It's not only our mission, it's our passion.
Sure, let's do it.
Splendid! Splendid. Now, let's see. Wonderful. That's everything. Just gonna walk this over to the vault. Congratulations on being prepared for the future.
Thanks again.
Hey, it's peace of mind. That's worth a little paperwork, right?
For you and Sean, no price is too high.
Good answer.
I have my moments.
Sir, Sean has been changed. But he absolutely refuses to calm down. I think he needs some of that paternal affection you seem to be so good at.
You heard Codsworth. Go on. How are the two most important men in my life doing? Spin the mobile a bit. He loves that. Hey, how's my little guy? Much better now, huh? Listen, after breakfast, I was thinking we could head to the park for a bit. Weather should hold up.
Will it be like that night in the park a year ago?
Sir? Mom? You should come and see this!
Codsworth? What's wrong?
Followed by... yes, followed by flashes, blinding flashes. Sounds of explosions. We're, trying to get confirmation.
What?
We seem to have lost contact with our affiliate stations. We do have coming in. That's, confirmed reports, I repeat, confirmed reports of nuclear detonations in New York and Pennsylvania. My God.
Oh my God.
We need to get to the vault. Now!
I've got Sean. Let's go.
Residents of Sanctuary Hills, if you are registered, evacuate to Vault 111 immediately.
Leave the bag! Who cares?
Just help me pack it up! If you're in the vault program, head to the gate!
It's absurd! I am
not on the list.
Tech.
You don't get in.
I'm going in. You can't stop
Sir.
Me.
Oh,
okay. I'm reporting this.
We need to get in. We're on the list.
Infant, adult male, adult female. Okay, go ahead.
Thank you.
Good luck,
you
ma'am.
You two, follow me.
God
Come
help
on.
Us all.
What's going to happen to all those people outside
We're
the
doing
gate?
Everything we can. Now keep moving. Step on the platform! In the center!
Alright, that's it! Send it down!
Almost there. We're gonna be okay. I love you. Both of you.
We love you too. Oh my God!
Hold on!
We did it. We made it. We're okay.
Everyone, please, step off the elevator and proceed up the stairs in an orderly fashion.
No need to worry, folks. We'll get everyone situated in your new home. Vault 111.
Vault Tech.
A better future
is here for you.
Underground.
Just this
way,
please.
Residents. Yes, up
please
the stairs.
Mail.
Sounds good.
Step over to the table, take a suit.
You'll need your suits before Welcome. We can take you further.
Pick up a Thanks.
Right over there.
What now?
Just follow the doctor here. He'll show you where to go.
All right, you three. Follow me.
See? This is our new home.
Oh, you're gonna love it here. This is one of our most advanced facilities. Not that the others aren't great, mind you.
This way, please.
It's gone. Our home. Everything we had.
Sir?
My mother and father down in D.C. Oh, God, honey.
How long do you think we'll be down here?
Move along.
Oh, we'll be going over all that in orientation. Just a few medical items we have to get through first.
Just checking everyone off the list.
The vault suit was designed to be fashionable as well as comfortable.
Prepared for the future, right?
Hey.
Just step in here and put your vault suit on. Step into the chamber whenever you're ready.
Shh. It'll be okay. Daddy's right here. See? Honey, could you help me?
Who's my little guy? I'm not going far. I'll just be over there.
There he is. See? Daddy's not going far.
All set? Just step inside and put on your pantsuit.
Hun?
I think he's better. You go ahead.
The pod will decontaminate and depressurize you before we head deeper in the vault. Just relax.
Time for a whole new life.
Resident secure. Occupant vitals normal. Procedure complete. In 5, 4, 3.
Come on! There has to be a release! Come on, come on, come on! Oh God!
I'll find who did this. And I'll get Sean back. Promise.
Giant roaches? What the hell? Where is everyone? Is this all that's left? Nice. Coming back later for you. Terminal somewhere. Is anyone alive? Did anyone get out?
Vault door cycling sequence initiated. Please stand back. Return to the surface, and thank you for choosing Vault Tech.
Thank you.
Codsworth?
As I live and breathe! Oh, it's really you!
Oh my God. This can't be happening. This isn't happening!
Isn't happening? What are you talking about? Oh my, but you look distraught! Oh, perhaps the missus can offer one of those hugs you humans are so fond of. Hmm? Speaking of which, where is your better half?
They killed her.
Sir, these things you're saying, these terrible things, I believe you need a distraction. Yes, a distraction to calm this dire mood. It's been ages since we've had a proper family activity. Checkers, or perhaps charades. Sean does so love that game. Is the lad with you?
Sean's been kidnapped. But I'm going to find him. I'm going to get my son back.
It's worse than I thought. Mm-hmm. You're suffering from hunger-induced paranoia. Not eating properly for 200 years will do that, I'm afraid.
200 years? What? Are you...
A bit over 210, actually, sir. Or give or take a little, for the Earth's rotation and some minor dings to the old chronometer. That means you're 2 centuries late for dinner. Perhaps I can whip you up a snack? You must be famished.
Codsworth, you're acting a little bit weird. What's wrong?
Oh, sir, it's been just horrible. 2 centuries with no one to talk to, no one to serve. I spent the first 10 years trying to keep the floors waxed, but nothing gets out nuclear fallout from vinyl wood. Nothing! And don't get me started about the futility of dusting a collapsed house. And the car! The car! How do you polish rust?
Whoa. Focus, Codsworth.
I'm afraid I don't know anything, sir. The bombs came and all of you left in such a hurry. I thought for certain you and your family were... dead. I did find this holotape. I believe the missus was going to present it to you as a surprise. But then, everything happened.
A holotape? What's on it?
I believe it's a private message for you. My etiquette protocols would not permit me to play it for myself. Any standard holotape reading device should be able to play it back. Oh, like that Pip-Boy on your arm. That should work brilliantly. Now, enough feeling sorry for myself. Shall we search the neighborhood together? The missus and young Sean may turn up yet.
There's nothing left here. It's all gone.
Well, if you wish to venture to parts unknown, I won't stop you. I shall guard the neighborhood in your absence.
Thank you.
Hey, boy. What are you doing out here all by yourself? You lose your owner, buddy.
Okay, then. Let's stick together.
Hey. Over here. Wait there.
How you doing, buddy?
Hey. Come on. Move here. Here. Head over there. Go there, there.
sir. Give me the word, sir, and I'll initiate my search protocols.
All right. Lead the way.
Proud to serve, sir. Picking up hostile peekaboo. Chop. Jolly good show, all right. What's all this then? How are you? I trust everyone's still alive. Wait. My senses are picking up movement in another house. Follow me.
Decided we were too much trouble.
Codsworth.
Sir, the Mrs. and young Sean, they aren't here.
Happy? This whole thing was a waste of time.
I only wanted to help, sir, but maybe you could try Cockhead. I've seen people in that area, and they're only slightly heavily armed.
Thanks for your help, Codsworth.
Good luck, sir. You'll find young Sean. I know you will. I shall remain here and secure the home front.
Hey, up here, on the balcony. I've got a group of settlers inside. The raiders are almost through the door. Grab that... First mistake, last mistake.
Got no reason to hang around and get shot.
Hey!
Let go!
Come on, man. They ain't going nowhere. We got other...
What? Fuck was that?
Shit. Open fire!
Man, I don't know who you are, but your timing's impeccable. Preston Garvey, Commonwealth Minutemen.
God damn it.
Minutemen? So now I'm traveling backward in time?
Protect the people at a minute's notice. That was the idea. So I joined up, wanted to make a difference. And I did, but things fell apart. Now it looks like I'm the last Minuteman left standing.
Nah, that ain't it.
Please, go on.
A month ago, there were 20 of us. Yesterday, there were 8. Now we're 5. First, it was the ghouls in Lexington, and now this mess.
It's a cruel world.
You think I don't know that? The things I've seen.
Nope.
The things I've done. Anyway, we figured Concord would be a safe place to settle. Those raiders proved us wrong. But
that ain't it.
Well, we do have one idea.
Will it be enough to stop those maniacs?
Sturgis, tell him.
There's a crashed vertebrate up on the roof. Old school, pre-war. You might have seen it. Well, looks like one of its passengers left behind a seriously sweet goodie. We're talking a full suit of Cherry T-45 power armor. Military issue.
What makes that power armor so special?
A Westech internalized servo system, that's what! Inside that baby, super is the new normal. You'll be stronger, tougher, resistant to rads, and... get the suit. You can rip the minigun right off the vertibird. Do that, and those raiders get an express ticket to hell. You dig?
Minigun. Now we're talking.
I know, right? Only there's one hitch. The suit's out of juice. Probably been dry for 100 years. It can be powered up again. But we're a bit stuck.
I'll help if I can.
What you'll need is an old pre-war FC. A standardized fusion core. Your high-grade, long-term nuclear battery used by the military and some companies way back when. And we know right where to find one.
But we can't get to the damn thing. It's down in the basement. Locked behind a security gate. Look, I fix stuff. I tinker. Bypassing security ain't exactly my forte. You could give it a shot.
I don't know. We'll see.
Well, it's not a no. Look, if you can get to the fusion core, jack it into that power armor, and grab the minigun, then those raiders will know they picked the wrong fight. Good luck.
here.
I got something over here.
Boss! We got somebody up!
Why don't you get down here? Show me that fancy gun up close. Not a lot of people can get past my boys. I'll give you that. Come on, I got places to be. To be. You're waiting, asshole. Come on, I've got places to be.
Take it easy, Mama. You okay?
I'm fine, Preston. Quit fussing.
That was a pretty amazing display. I'm just glad you're on our side.
The feeling's mutual, Preston.
You can never have too many friends. Not in the Commonwealth. Listen, when we first met, you asked about the Minutemen. One thing you should know about us, we help out our friends. So here, for everything you've done, thank you.
You're welcome. Anytime.
Well, since you say that, maybe you'll come to Sanctuary with us. We could use your help getting settled there.
All right, Garvey. I'm in.
Oh, that's wonderful. But there's more to your destiny, isn't there? I've seen it, and I know your pain.
Don't give me that destiny crap.
I just saw you go toe-to-toe with a 20-foot-tall irradiated lizard. You telling me you can't keep an open mind after that?
It's all right, Preston. Not everyone understands the sight. But I don't need you to believe. I just need you to listen. You're a man out of time, out of hope. But all's not lost. I can feel your son's energy. He's alive.
I knew it. Please tell me where he is. I need to find my son.
I can't see him. Not clearly, but I feel his life force. He's out there. And even I don't need the sight to tell you where you should start looking. The great green jewel of the Commonwealth. Diamond City. The biggest settlement around.
What's in Diamond City? Is Sean there?
Look, kid. I'm tired now. Maybe you'll bring me some chems later. The sight will paint a clearer picture.
No. Mama Murphy, we talked about this. That junk. It's gonna kill you.
Aw, shush, Preston. We're all gonna die eventually. We're gonna need the sight. And our new friend here, he's gonna need it too. Now let's get going. Sanctuary awaits.
All right, folks. Thanks to our friend here, it's safe to move out. We're heading for that place Mama Murphy knows about. Sanctuary. It's not far.
She knows about it? You mean she had one of her visions while she was stoned out of her gourd? And now you want us to just head out on another wild goose chase based on no better plan than Mama Murphy saw it?
It can hardly turn out any worse than...
Everybody just take it easy. We're all in this together, right? So Marcy, you got a better idea of what we should do next? Anybody? Well then, Sanctuary it is. Let's just hope it lives up to its name.
Come on, June, it's time to go.
Sounds like you better get going to Diamond City.
I'm sure Preston can handle anything we find until we reach Sanctuary.
Where are we going, Marcy?
Don't worry, June. Just stay with me. It'll be fine.
Okay.
Careful here, Mama.
Thank you.